So the other day I was thinking about the benefit of journaling. People ask me and I talk about of journaling a lot in my videos, and I'm a huge favor of writing. You should start your day by doing journaling because there are a lot of benefits of it. So in this video, I'm going to tell you how journaling helps you to become the best version of yourself. In you could say 1 month, 2 months, 3 months, it depends how much you do journaling with consistency. So let's start it. So first thing is, you have to do this intentionally. Everything you have to start your day with the journaling. How you can do it? First you have to write. Let me tell you, the first question is, why should we even do a journaling? So first thing is, you have to write everything in your notebook and everything, and just analyze how far you have come in your life and how far you want to go in your life. So if you don't write it down, so everything get mixed up in your mind and you are not able to do anything intentionally, and you will not be able to achieve anything in your life. So you have to start journaling and just think about it, that what mistake you made in your life and how you can avoid these mistakes in your future, because every effect is a, every action is a reaction, or you have to face consequences of it. So you have to be intentional and you have to write it down, positive things, negative things and everything, and what things are bothering you and you just keep thinking about it and you are just keep extremely worried about those things. You have to write it down initially, and then what's your beliefs and what you really want to do with your beliefs, and how you can either your beliefs are harming you or others, and you really need to write it down everything. You have to be intentional and do it first day in the morning. And the first thing is, in the initial stage of your journaling, what you have to do is just don't care about, and you don't need to follow any kind of structure for journaling in the initial stage, first stage you could say. So what you have to do is, you just write it down, whatever going on in your mind, especially if your mind is not fresh, you are not able to do anything in your life. So it's really important, whatever is going on in your mind, just write it down, and just it either is good, bad, and what your triggers point and everything. It doesn't matter what, if something going on in your workplace, in your family, if you are facing any kind of issues in your family, in your workplace, everything, just write it down. You are not able to achieve your goals, or you want to go to somewhere for higher studies, you are not able to achieve that goal. You want to become financially independent, you are facing any kind of financial issue, just write it down everything. And just if you want to buy anything for yourself, just, and you, it's in your to-do list, just write it down every day. This is the first stage, so you will understand that what's going on in your brain. So what happens is that you will learn that you have no idea how much relaxed you feel after doing that kind of journaling. So after that, what you have to do is, as I told you, you don't need any kind of structure at that time. So what you have to do is, you have to now do the structured journaling. Now you have to do the journaling intentionally. How you can do it? You have to be very careful. You can say that you have to write it down in this stage, that what things I am blessed with, or show gratitude towards those things, like I wanted to get that job and luckily I got it, I'm very thankful for it. I have a pure water in my house, I have enough money to survive a month here, and so many years. So you have to show gratitude, so you are able to talk nicely, and you know, and you are educated, and just a small little thing, you are blessed and you are just show gratitude. So you care about people, and you have to be thankful to Almighty that you are able to do this thing, and just write it down every day, and write down your blessings. And it doesn't matter, you are living in a good house, you have an AC in this scorching heat, so be thankful for that. You are able to buy anything, whatever you want, whenever you want, just write it down everything, and the things you are very grateful. So like, this is a watch, see, okay, I bought it from my job earning, or you can say for my, when I starting my job initially. So that's, I'm really proud of myself that I was able to, I'm very grateful that I was able to buy this watch from my earning, first income. So I'm really grateful for it. I'm not in a sense, and I don't need to show up to any other person, but I'm very grateful that I did the hard work, that I was able to afford this and I make myself eligible to, so I can buy this watch. So I'm really happy for it. So, and I'm very grateful, and it's a blessing kind of. So thanks to Almighty for it. And also what you can do to improve your happiness and be thankful more. And so you have to work on these things. This is a gratitude journaling you are doing intentionally. So it's all about your blessings and your gratefulness and your happiness. So write it down, what things make you happy. So you have to work on that thing. And now it's time to key points journaling. So now again, you have to be very concise and very intentional in this stage as well. You have to write it down, what you have to write it down. Let's break it down. I'm not going and in favor of just talk about the long-term things. Just review your whole year progress, what you have to do, what happened, main events, either is family related, something got sick, you lost your job, you just achieved something, you just buy something big, or you just, whatever you did, main events go bang in a year. So you have to write it down intentionally, and in a month and years you have to be intentional and write it down everything. And either it's good or bad, it doesn't matter, you have to write it down, your years, year happening. So, and then you, what you have to do, this is a part of that key points journaling. So what you have to do now, you have to write down your goals, what you want to, you just analyze your whole year. Now it's time to move forward and then work on your goals again, that how can improve myself better, and work on those things and break it down everything. It doesn't matter that you have to break it down everything about your goals. If you want to go to abroad for a master's, so what you have to do, you just, you, it's not by light, right? You just can't just start thinking about it and just you have to do your hard work. What you have to do, you just search universities, write it down, and just shortlist your universities, and you have to search the location, countries, which and you have to do the budgeting as well, how you can manage the expenses and everything, and what documents you need, what things you do, IELTS, GRE, everything, you write it down, everything. That's how you can break it down your goals. So it's just an example, okay? So, and then what you have to do is, you just do the key point blanks. Now if you really want to be happy in your life, so you have, as I told you, that this is the most important things. At the end, it's all about your happiness. If you are not happy from inside and just pretending to be happy in front of others, in your workplace and in front of your family, so whatever you are doing, either it's about your goal, it's about buying anything or everything, so, but if you are not happy from inside, it's just, everything is useless, because it all depends on your happiness. Because whatever you are doing is to make yourself happy, but despite everything, you are not able to be happy internally, and you are not able to convey and communicate with other people and show what's going on inside. And you don't need to do that as well, because you have to sort it out, this issue on your own self. So what, how you can do it, rather than going to a very expensive therapy, I'm very huge favor of it. If you are facing any kind of difficulty, you have to go to the therapy, it's normal. Or those who are just against it, I don't argue with them, it's their opinion. But you have to go to the therapy to make and sort it out all issues, what's going on in your inside. And so what the easiest thing you can do is to start journaling. How you can do it, just, you have to be very, you can say, very sincere to yourself, very honest with yourself in this matter, and just write it down, all the painful experiences, emotional experiences which you had to experience, despite whatever the reason was, you had to go through that experience. Either it's in your childhood, you had to go through some kind of trauma, you lost your loved ones all of a sudden, and it's affected your mind very badly, that still after so many years you are not able to process that loss, and you just feel so empty and loneliness from inside, and you are not able to just overcome that space in your heart. So what you have to do is, you have to write it down, everything in that painful emotional experiences journaling section. So if you do this thing almost for a week at least, you have no idea how much you feel light from inside. It doesn't matter, either it could be about your job loss, which you are very attached, and you just got that job after praying so many hours and asking so many, after doing so much hard work. So what you have to do, you have to be write it down as very, I know it's natural, but some people are so much sensitive and they are just take it everything so personally. So you have to, you are very emotional about that job and anything. So you have to write it down, that thing, into your journal, and just write it down how you are feeling about that loss and everything. So if you are doing this, you are doing a very huge favor, and you will be able to find a solution for it, and you will start and accepting the loss of your loved ones or loss of your job. So you really need to be careful and just be honest with yourself. It's really important. Right now in this era, no one is open and want to talk about these kind of things. So you have to do it for your own self, and you will find and start again enjoying your life in a very meaningful way. So after that, what you have to do is, again, now after doing every section, now it's time to planning your future. So where do you want to go from the stage you are in right now? What goals you want to achieve? What's your plan? And what's what things you want to learn? And where you want to go for your studies? What area, what country you want to go for travel in your vacation? And just everything, write it down for your future goals. And you have to do this with consistency, this kind of journaling consistency, for at least 3 months. You will find and you will feel very happy while you doing this, because whatever you write it down in your journal, while doing your journaling, so what happens is that you just start working on those things you are not able to achieve in a certain time. So that's really important to write it down, everything, and remind yourself that I want to do this thing, I want to do this thing, I want to do this thing. So it will definitely affect you in a very positive way. So it's really important, work on these things and you will able to see the solution, and you will achieve a lot of things within no time. So hope it's helped you a lot, and I'm in a very huge favor of journaling. Do writing, it doesn't matter, it's whatever just going on in your mind. It's really important to talk about yourself and care about yourself, what you want and what's your need. So it's really important. So that's it for now. Hope you like this video. If you have any question, if you want to talk about anything, just share with me. I will definitely get back to you. Thank you so much. Bye.